CoQ10 or coenzyme Q10 is one of the most popular supplements out there. In fact, it's a nutrient that's already produced naturally in the body. It's in virtually all cells and mostly concentrated in the mitochondria or the powerhouse of the cell. And because CoQ10 is a powerful antioxidant, it can protect your brain, heart, and muscles. But as we age, CoQ10 levels decline. In this video, we will look at five of the most studied benefits of CoQ10, how much CoQ10 you really need, what you should look at when you're choosing a best CoQ10 product. So definitely stay tuned till the end and we'll cover all of it. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you guys to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive into CoQ10. You see, the primary biochemical action of CoQ10 is being a cofactor in the electron transport chain, which is a series of redox reactions that are involved in making ATP, which is how your cells make and spend their energy. And as most functions in the body are dependent on adequate supplies of ATP in order for you to walk, run, breathe, and just basically do everything, CoQ10 is essential for the health of virtually all human tissues and organs, especially the organs, right? Because the highest concentrations are found in organs with the greatest energy demands, like your heart, kidneys, lungs, and liver. And the first benefit of CoQ10 is found in the heart conditions, primarily as a way to improve symptoms of congestive heart failure, as it may actually help reduce blood pressure, especially if you have coronary artery disease and high blood pressure. These conditions can cause oxidative damage and inflammation of the veins and arteries, which CoQ10 may actually help prevent. This study looked at 420 people with heart failure, and with treatment with CoQ10 for 2 years, they were able to see improved symptoms and reduced heart complications. The second benefit is with diabetes, and it's been seen that abnormal mitochondrial function may lead to insulin resistance, which is a complication of diabetes. And when it comes to CoQ10 and insulin, CoQ10 may improve insulin sensitivity and regulate blood sugar levels. Not only that, but it might have a preventative role in diabetes, as it can help break down fats and reduce accumulation of fat cells, which leads to either obesity or diabetes. But what about A1C? This study that looked at 50 people for 12 weeks found that the CoQ10 group saw lower fasting blood sugar levels and hemoglobin A1C, which, as you know, is the average of your blood sugar levels over the past 3 months. The third benefit is helping with myopathy caused by statins. And I have a separate video here that you can refer to about CoQ10 statins if you want more details. But the research on this is mixed, but the idea is that CoQ10 might help ease the muscle weakness and pain sometimes associated with taking statins, which if you're on statins, you definitely know what I'm talking about. The fourth benefit is how it can help with migraines. You see, chronic migraines may be caused from the inflammation of neurons and cells in parts of the brain called the trigeminal vascular system, and particularly been tied back to CGRP, which is the calcitonin gene-related peptide, which has been shown to be released during migraine attacks and may actually cause the migraine attacks to get worse. This 2018 clinical trial looked at 45 women with episodic migraines and found that the women who took 400 milligram daily doses of either CoQ10 or a placebo found the women who took the CoQ10 supplements had fewer and less intense migraines when compared to the placebo group because of how it decreased CGRP and TNF-alpha, which I thought was super interesting. And lastly, the fifth benefit is with physical performance. This is because of how it can increase oxygen uptake, or the VO2 max, which basically means oxygen is getting into the cells faster so they can function properly. Also, interestingly, CoQ10 can help recycle your vitamin E, which means you end up keeping more vitamin E, which if you don't know, vitamin E helps with producing red blood cells and getting oxygen to the tissues and organs, which is important for athletes. Now that you got to look at some of the benefits, let's take a look at how much you really need. You see, the whole body content of CoQ10 is only about 500 to 1500 milligrams, and that will decrease with age. And a typical CoQ10 dose is about 30 to 90 milligrams per day, but also can be taken as high as 200 milligrams per day. And keep in mind that CoQ10 is a fat soluble, so it's better absorbed when taken with a meal that contains oil or fat. And it's perfectly normal if you don't see any results right away, because the clinical effects can take at minimum 8 weeks for any ubiquinone or ubiquinol product. And in terms of the side effects you can experience are headache, nausea, stomach ache, and interestingly being sensitive to light. But overall, CoQ10 is generally safe and recommended by many cardiologists around the world. The interactions you should watch for are definitely going to be with your blood thinners, insulin, and if you're on chemotherapy. Then it may be best to avoid it if you fall underneath any of those. And as far as which product of CoQ10 I recommend, the one by Thorne Research seems to be a great one at 100 milligram optimally absorbed ubiquinone, which Thorne, if you don't know, is the only supplement manufacturer to collaborate with Mayo Clinic on wellness research and content. And they have a unique CoQ10 delivery system, which makes them stand out, called QBEST, which is optimally dissolved CoQ10 in a lipid form, giving greater absorption in the gut. Now, you don't need to go with this one, but I did leave my link down below for this one specifically, so you could pick it up from the description box down below. Click that red subscribe button down below if you found any value in this, and I'll see you guys on the next one.